is a beautiful spot below the 7 Mile Dam in Spokane, Washington.
Non ti trai farfalloni amoroso, notte giorno di torno trato, delle belle turbando a riposo, ma ci sento a tuo cino d'amore.
And there's some, looks like some merganser ducks out here on this rock.
Fra guerrieri po' farbacco, grando stacchi stretto sacco, schioppo in spalla, ciabla a fianco, collo dritto, muso franco, un gran casco, un gran turbante, molto onor, poco cantante, poco cantante. E del fandango, una marcia per il fango, per montagni, per valloni, con nevi e soglioni, al concerto di tromboni, di condanne e di cannoni, delle barre e tutti i tuoni, all'orecchio far fischiar. Non più frai, quei temechini, non più frai, quel cappello, non più frai.
Hi.
Non più frai, quell'aria brillante.
Look at this. Must be for measuring the river when we have spring runoff. Look at this amazing tree. Hi everyone! Just out taking my dog for a walk and seeing what's going on. And it's a beautiful day to be outside. So let's go see what else we can find. Look at all the garbage. There just wasn't enough. We have these bags with us. And look at all this over here. Just don't have enough room for all of it. Pretty gross, Spokane. That's where the garbage can is. Okay, so here is a look at what a lot of landscape around Spokane looks like. This is a pine forest. These trees have pretty shallow roots. They tend to fall over in windstorms. Some people in town had some trouble with this about 2 years ago. And also a lot of dry pine needles beneath the trees, and that provides a lot of fuel for forest fires. Isn't that gorgeous? Bring me the stick. Give it to me. It's right there. Give it to me. Give it, get it. Right here, right here. Yeah. Oh. Yeah. Oh. Oh my gosh. All right, ready? Get it.
Per montagni, per valloni,
You ready? I don't want to throw it too far, make him work too hard. He's a big boy and he's 11 years old. Give me a stick. Alright, ready? I think we should go now. I think that you're old and we gotta take it easy. We can't do too much, okay? Okay, good boy. It is remarkable that none of the salmon who come up this length ever return to the sea. They continue growing, going against the current, till they actually starve. Alexander Kennedy, Spokane House Journal, 1823. Spokane House, late May and early June, marked the eagerly anticipated arrival of the spring Chinook salmon runs. Although other species of salmon and trout were found in the Spokane and Little Spokane, the early Chinooks were prized by traders and tribal people because of their generous size, succulent flesh, and large runs. Wow, look at these. As a traditional trading center for fish, horses, and other goods, the mouth of the Little Spokane was an ideal location for a trading post. During 1822 and 1823, traders Finan McDonald and James Burney recorded visits from numerous plateau tribes in the Spokane House Journal. This one says, July 17, 1822, I promised a pipe stem with a piece of tobacco to the earring, Pondere Chief. This is so neat. I wonder who did this. I wonder if it was some of the students from the local college. I know my sister took a class out there and they learned how to use materials and hunt and gather. And I think that was in her cultural anthropology class at SFCC. But it's amazing. Look, that was just a bark from the trees. How cool is that? Here is the Spokane House Interpretive Center. And the hours are Saturday and Sunday, 10 to 4. Oh, I see guano. Yuri? No guano. Stay. Bat poo, bat poo. Bats and bat houses. Can you hear them? Mural on the side of the Spokane House Interpretive Center, showing the Little Spokane River. It's just a beautiful day. I'm so glad that I stopped. The cicadas stop singing as well.